Alright guys, welcome back. We're now approximately at 15,000 feet. We're continuing our descent down to 6,000 and then we'll transition down to 3,000 for a final approaching altitude. We turned on seatbelt sign. We decided not to turn on the engine anti-ice as of yet. We'll do that once we reach close to the clouds, so around 10,000 feet. Yeah, we're just waiting to reach 10,000 to do our next procedure, next flows. And yeah, I can't believe it's turning dark already. It's literally just a flight, and it already turns dark. You can already see the lights in the distance there, or between the clouds. Quite nice, and the clouds are looking really nice. If you guys are wondering what clouds I use, I have purchased a pack for $10 on the Auric. It's one of those enhancement packs just for clouds themselves. So yeah, they actually look really good, and I think it's worth the $10. Plus active sky using default clouds, so having the default cloud enhanced package is quite nice to have for sure. We're just lagging a little bit here with loading and scenery and all that good stuff. Alright. As you can see, we're getting quite close to the clouds. Probably a good time to test to see if the fog clouds actually can cast HDR lights. So if I turn on landing lights, it'll actually display on the clouds. I wonder if that all works, but we'll see. If I remember correctly, I don't think it does, but we'll have to see again. So nice seeing clouds and like just a little glimpses of life down there. It's so refreshing and so surreal. It's like surreal looking. It's been a while since I've done Flight Simulator. I think I did one flight yesterday. And yeah. So I'm rusty with landings and all that, so we'll see how well I do. You probably already noticed on the takeoff I was really shaky, although I'm always like that. I don't know. Taking off on the X plane is kind of shaky and not very stable compared to Prepared or FSX, which I've never played that much. I mean, I have some videos, but that's about it. The only time I would go back to FSX or Prepared is honestly for their aircraft and for FS2Crew. Once X-Plane gets FS2Crew or somewhat similar to that, not necessarily FS2Crew, I am never going back. Even now, I'm never going back. Alright, so landing lights coming on. The constraint, this is about the time we'll hear an announcement. I guess once we pass 10,000. Alright, ILS push button or landing system push buttons turned on 3 times. It comes back to constraints. We're now going down to 3,000. Decelerating. I'm going to go and stow our tables. Engine anti-ice can come on. We're about to hit the clouds here. And, there's also a couple other things we check for nav accuracy. I don't think they've simulated that as well. No, it's always 0.08. Yeah, and we'll now do the approach checklist. We do have to get our transition, our QNH, which was 1009. So we'll go and enter that now too, since we're descending below our transition altitude. Set. We'll go and extend our speed brake just a little bit here. We're getting quite close, so I want to decelerate our plane here to at least 230. So I'm going to extend our speed break just a little bit more. Also want to descend. Two two zero. Go and extend flaps one. Oh, what happened there? We're going arm. So I don't see any landing lights casting on to the shadow or on the clouds. So I'm guessing not. Look at that. Beautiful. Oh, stupid update. Should be at 190 once we're close to reaching our glide slope. glass slope. Down for flaps 2. Approach phase is activated, we'll go to down to 1.7, actually 1.60. Speed. Flaps 3. Flaps 4. Okay. Landing checklist. Cam signal is given. Auto throttle speed. Landing gear is down in 3 green. Eco memo is landing in blue. Disconnect our autopilot and we're landing it. The last review here. Beautiful. Alright, let's concentrate now.
1,000.
Check.
Approaching 1.5. Check.
300. 200. 100. 50. 40. 30. 20. Retard. Retard. 5.
Okay.
Remaining.
There's a runway. Just
approaching. 2, 3.
I'll go and stay, go and hold right here. Let's go and clean up the aircraft. Auto and standby. Let's see if we hear an announcement. Yep, there we go. Okay, if you start. Checklist. Flaps are retracted. Landing lights are off. Spoilers are disarmed. Radar predictive winchers off. Stantica standby APU is starting and coming on. Okay. Gate, if they coming on, taxi light coming off. I think I missed it a little bit. Yep, okay. No problem. NTS would also come off if we still needed it on the ground. Pressure check. Alright, that's checked. That's what's coming off. Make sure slides disarm, which they do. Beacon coming off. Seatbelt signs can come off. Fuel pumps coming off. Left time paused. That is the flight complete? Now do a couple checks, check our fuel quantity, so let's go ahead and do that right now. Check PFPX, see what they wanted us to have at the end of the flight. About 3.36, we got 3.46, so we got 100 kilograms more, which is perfect. Exactly what we needed and wanted. Transponder, make sure it's all standby, which it is, and this needs to go to all. A little late now, but did it anyways. Go and do all this. Don't need our radios anymore. Turn that off. We'll go ahead and connect our external power as well as our trucks and open our left door. Plug the external power. Turn off that. Navin logo off and off. Deers come off as well. It's all checked. We'll reset our timers. Go and dim CDUs. Displays. Parking checklist, parking brake and chocks are in, engines are off, beacon is off, seatbelt signs are off, emergency aids lights are off, yellow electric pumps off, and fuel pumps are off. Okay. And now the secure checklist, parking brake is on, and gears are off, oxygen is off. Turn off the batteries as well. Which is not simulated, so oxygen can't be off, but we'll just say it's off. Exterior lights are all off. Cabin lights and emergency lights are off, and batteries are off. So we can go and turn off the external power, and that is it. The flight is complete. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this entire thing, and if you have any suggestions, any planes I should fly, or any airports I should visit, just let me know, and I'll consider it. Thank you again, and until next time. Bye.